If when you use a secondary scale, you have this type of problem. So here we go from zero to a number. For whatever reason, this one goes to negative. So you'll see it's a bit hard to actually see what's happening here. So what we want to do is make sure the chart automatically starts at the same place. So the way to do that, here's my data and it's currently connected to it. We're going to create two new helper columns. So I'm going to call this primary scale and secondary scale. And all I'm going to do just over here, I'm going to say equals minimum of all these numbers. So I've highlighted that whole section. For the secondary scale, I'm actually going to just go equals to that one. So you can redo it, but it doesn't matter. Over here, we're going to say is a maximum of all these numbers. And similarly, we're going to go and just make that one equal to. It's better not to copy it. So now we've got that. What I'm now going to do, I'm just going to quickly shortcut, I'm just going to add these two on. And you'll see for now it's a little bit of a mess, still not quite working out the way we want. Where this now becomes important, I'm going to just right click here. I'm going to say change series chart type. So what you'll see is we've got revenue and profit, and that's on the secondary scale, so that's fine. And what I want to do is the primary scale should not be on the secondary axis. So I'm going to just switch that off. Secondary scale should be on the secondary axis. So once you get those correct, I'm going to say okay. And you'll see now already it looks better. What this is forcing it to do is that this one needs to come up with an item, and because of the way we've set it up, it will be exactly the same set of numbers. Now you'll see it's actually listed here. And if we had a different type of chart here, we'd actually see it. So we'll be a little bit careful. In this case, it's not as problematic. Now, these are, you'll see it's very hard to see. So for me, the easiest way, I just want to go and look at the primary scale. I'm going to go to Format. And over here, I'm going to say I'm looking for this thing called primary scale. And you'll see it's highlighted, it's actually over there. And just to make sure that if we change the style of the chart, it doesn't cause a problem, I'm going to say there must be no line. And if there was a marker, again, no line there. So those all look fine, it should be fine. So that does the primary scale. I would then go look at the secondary scale. Same thing, just make sure that when you change it, if you change it to another type of chart, you don't see it. If you do see it, it's just a case of hiding it. Make the color the same as the background, no line, no fill, etc. And what you have now is something that will, the chart always looks the same. You can actually see where the profit goes negative, a little bit easier to read. And if these numbers change, so let's make this negative 30. You'll see the chart has automatically adapted because this scale now knows it has to go from the minimum number to the maximum number.